Hello everybody, this is Abraham with North Shore Computer Services. What we have here is a multi-fold problem. This is 2021 and I believe the OS Big Sur is the current operating system on the Mac. As you can see, this one is running El Capitan. The computer cannot be upgraded to newer operating system, not because it can't support it. It can support it. This is a 2015 model, but because there is not enough space. If you look, this is what's on the screen. Let me see if I could zoom in a little bit. All of this space is taken by other. What is this other stuff? We have deleted everything from the computer. I should say the person who owns the computer deleted everything and still has no space left on the hard drive. Granted, this is a small hard drive. It's only 128 gigabytes. Other, what is taking all that space? So let's see if we can do some investigative work and find where is all this space being eaten. All right, for that we're gonna do several things. First, we're gonna open Finder and we're just gonna go to our hard drive. If we push Command A, that selects all of the folders on our hard drive, and then we put the cursor on any of the folders, and we use, let me zoom out so it can be easier to see. Oops. Okay, so we use two fingers and we click on any of the folders and it's gonna give us a menu and we get a click on get info. That will pop up all of the folders and it's gonna tell us which folder is the elephant in the room. Let me zoom in here. Too close. All right. We have applications. That's 15 gigabytes. It's big, but not huge, and this is applications. We have library. That's 5 gigabytes. We have system. That's 8 gigabytes. And we have users. That's 83 gigabytes. There is our elephant right there. The users folder. Okay. So we close all that. And now we're just going to go into users folder. So we have three folders in here. Same thing, control, command A. Control A is on Windows machines. Command A. Two fingers, get info. Shared is a couple of kilobytes. Guest is nothing, 3 bytes. Well, 3 bytes. And the main user's account is 83 gigabytes. Okay, so we know it's hidden in main user's account. So let's go here. There's a bunch of folders in here, and if we do Command A and then do same thing, get info, I'm gonna open all of them. And as we can see on all of these info pages, there is not enough to add up to 80 gigabytes. We have 1 megabyte, 1 gigabyte, 3 gigabyte, 6 gigabyte, 0 byte, 13 kilobytes, 0, 1.8, 1.9, and another. All of this together may add up to maybe 10 gigabytes, but where is the other 80? All right, close that. In order for us to find what's eating all that space, we're gonna have to enable hidden files. So this is what's visible when you use the computer as a normal user, but there is a lot of stuff in the home folder that is not visible. So we're gonna open terminal. There are several ways you can do it. You can go to applications, utilities, folders. You can do search, or like I already have it open. And we're gonna put in this command in there. It is defaults. Right. com, period, Apple, period, Finder. Space, Apple. Now you have to make sure that you obey capitalization, because as I found out, this is case sensitive. So Apple, A-P-P-L-E, and Apple is capitalized, show, S-H-O-W, all, A-L-L, files, F-I-L-E-S, true. Okay, so we have defaults, space, right, space, com dot, apple dot, finder, space, apple, show, all files, true. All right, you hit enter and it just comes back. Now we have to basically reinitialize the finder, and we do kill all, K-I-L-L-A-L-L, and then capitalized F-I N-D-E-R, oops, space, kill all, space, capitalized finder. I'll put those in down in the description, those commands. That resets the finder, and when it comes back, we can see that there are more folders hidden in that home file, home folder. Let's keep looking. One of the suspects that I think is library folder. So let's just view, get info on the library. 70 gigabytes, that is our culprit right there. If we go to the library, oh come on, open, we can see that there is quite a bit of stuff in here, and trying to find which folder is taking space is going to be difficult, because you'd have to do info on every folder, and then each folder has a subfolder and subfolder. Now that we know that the culprit is in the library folder, it's probably best that we use some help. As you can see, on the desktop, there are hidden files that have shown up that weren't there before. and those files are aborted. This is Word and Excel files that have somehow got stuck, and they're sitting in half-baked form. If you open the actual file and the system sees that there is a file in there, it'll give you a prompt: do you want to recover a previous version or something like that. So that's what these are. These can be deleted. But here's what we're gonna do. We are going to open this program. It's called Grand Perspective. It's a free program available on the internet. We're going to point to our home folder, and we're gonna look at what is taking the space. The scan will take some time, and then it'll give you this kind of interesting graph. Let's see if we can make it bigger. Yeah. This graph beautifully shows every folder that is taking space. I love how they have it. Unfortunately, on this particular version of the computer or the program or whatever, if you double click, it doesn't take you to that folder. But at the bottom, it does show you which folder is taking a lot of space. And in my case, it is library, application support, mobile sync, backup, blah, blah, blah. Okay, that's number one. Second big one. Library, application support, mobile sync, backup. So all this space is taken by some backup of mobile stuff. This is another big one. Library, application support, mobile sync, backup. So if we go to our dreaded folder, oops, that's the terminal window, don't need that. And we're gonna go to library. Let's find a mobile sync. Huh, I don't see mobile sync. Oh, application support, see? All right, so library application support. There it is. Mobile sync. Mobile sync right here, backup, and there is a bunch of stuff in here. Here it is. This is all backup of some kind that was done in 2017. That's just not fair. So this stuff is sitting here and taking my valuable space on a small hard drive. It's not even useful. It's nothing. So let's see if we can delete it. Move to trash. Easy peasy. Move to trash. Easy peasy. And let's see if we can rescan. So I'm expecting these big bubbles to disappear. They didn't. All right. Oh, because now they're in trash. Oh, come on. Empty trash. Yes. All right, rescan. I don't know what that mobile sync is, but it certainly is not needed here. See? Different ones now. Okay. So this one is iTunes. Okay, so this is some movie from the iTunes. This is photo library. Okay, that's normal. There is downloads, Mac OS upgrade, and movies. Okay, I didn't realize that there was an upgrade waiting, but it's only 2 gigabytes. Okay, let's go to, oh cool, this is the old version. It stayed. Wow, every time you run a sync it creates a new picture. I love that. All right, let's go back to about this Mac and storage, and voila, look, we got all that space, plenty of space to run an upgrade. All right, so that's good. Let's clean up some more by deleting this stuff from the desktop. It's definitely not needed. Move to trash. Move to trash. Move to trash. Okay, so now we know that the desktop is cleaned up. Don't need that anymore. Let's re-enable the hidden, or let's hide the files. So all we need to do is just up arrow, that gives us the back command, default, right, com, Apple Finder, Apple show all files, true. And we're just gonna replace the true to false. And next command we're gonna run is kill all finder. That restarts the finder, and poof, all of the files have disappeared. All right, so this is how we clean up the space on a computer. Once that's cleaned up, now we're gonna need to go to downloads folder apparently, because it looks like there is stuff in there that's not needed. Yeah, there's quite a bit of stuff in downloads. You gotta be careful deleting things from downloads, because there may be something that is needed, but I know for sure, let's sort by size, biggest on top, Mac OS update. I don't even know which version this is. To 10.13. Okay. It's not necessary. I'm not going to be updating it to that version. We're going to go to a much newer version. All right. If this helped somebody, give me a like. If you like my videos, subscribe, enjoy, save money.